Purdue University is an international leader in technology transfer and startup creation. One of those startups is FORSUGO Hi-Cell, which is commercializing a Purdue innovation that could help prevent terrorist attacks with radiological dirty bombs and nuclear weapons by tracking such weapons through smartphones. FORSUGO Hi-Cell President Ron Jones said the technology is an important tool in protecting society.
The best use of the technology is the individual cell phone carrier. There are 1 billion cell phones sold every year. So if you had the technology in every cell phone, you have 1 billion people searching for nuclear material worldwide. The environment is constantly being mapped. You take a record of the environment so you will know what natural radioactive material you have in the environment. And if something appears in the environment that is out of order, it sets off an alert. The information will be transitioned to the local, regional, state, national police force, telling them at a certain time, at a certain location, nuclear materials were discovered in this amount, which puts them in a position to physically send one of their agents there to specifically investigate that location.
The technology also has the ability to use a smartphone's GPS and data connection to determine the location of potential threats and relay the data to a central hub. For example, someone with a backpack-sized nuclear device could set off detector smartphones while walking down the street. Then officials could use the GPS data to identify the approximate location and threat of the device.
In addition to the individual cell phone user, the technology can be mounted in traffic signal lights, neighborhood lighting, police vehicles, ambulances. It can also be mounted around airports. It can also be mounted around maritime ports. It is a very cost-effective technology.
The technology could be available by mid-2016.
In addition to sensing the nuclear landscape, the device can also sense the biological or chemical landscape of an area. On a biological end, it could sense anthrax or ricin if it's released. On the chemical end, it could sense ammonia or chlorine that are common elements for bomb making.
To find more information on this and other Purdue technologies, visit otc-prf.org/otc.